Neil D. Silva is an Indian author who is known for writing in horror genre. He is one of the most popular Indian authors of this time who writes horror. His very first novel, Maya's New Husband, catapulted him to fame in 2015. And since then, he has written a bunch of novels and short story collections that I am going to talk about in this video. If you're new here, hi there, I'm Anvita. I make book-related videos on this channel. If you're into bookish content, then please make sure you subscribe to me and hit a thumbs up to support this channel. And now let's get started with this video. So Neil D. Silva has written three horror novels. We'll start with his debut novel, Maya's New Husband, which is more of a psychological horror story about Maya, who is a woman who lives in Mumbai and is a school teacher, and then she meets a guy named Bhaskar Sadachari. And after a very short romance, she marries this guy, after which the horrors in her life begin. The book is set in a backdrop of serial killings in Mumbai and has themes of cannibalism, Indian agori ritualism, etc. Now, personally, I have not read any Neil D. Silva books, but he is the author who is at the top of my TBR because I'm so much interested in his works, which is why I'm making this video, so that if you find the time, you definitely need to check all of these horror works of Neil D. Silva. Number two book is a paranormal romance and it's called Pisach. Now, there is a flesh-eating demon called Pisach who falls in love with a human named Nitika. Now, the problem is Nitika is already in love with somebody else. And now the Pisach realizes that if he wants Nitika to love him, then he needs to be a human. And to make that possible, he is ready to leave no stone unturned. He would fight with beasts, giants, witches, and even the god himself. And within this universe, there is a secret that could be even more devastating than what is happening now in this story. So this book really has themes of history, mythology, romance, and obviously horror. Number three novel of Neil D. Silva is Yakshini. It is again a supernatural novel with a mix of Indian mythology. It is a story of a simple Maharashtrian girl named Meenakshi who finds out that there is somebody else living inside her body. And now this entity living within her is starting to have its own life and has begun to do things which are not so good. So this book is really about Meenakshi's battles with the entity living within her as well as with the male dominated society, because this entity really reacts to that part of her life a lot. Although all of Neil D. Silva's books are really popular, especially Maya's New Husband, but this book is also quite talked about on social media for its themes related to feminism and everything. It really ignited a discussion about that. Now Neil D. Silva has five collections of short stories. The number one of those is The Evil Eye and the Charm, which is a collection of six short stories. The common theme in all of those short stories is the debate between science and superstition. And obviously the stories are about different things. For example, an infant who is possessed or a deadly curse on a child, or a man mocking the Nimbu Mirchi superstition we have and, you know, the repercussions of that. I believe that's how the book derives its name, The Evil Eye and the Charm, because the charm, Nimbu Mirchi one, that we use is supposed to keep the evil eye away and, you know, all that. I am just speculating about this. Moving on to the second short story collection by Neil D. Silva. Bound in Love is a collection of eight short stories that reveal the darker side of human beings. The topics of these short stories include like having a difficult relationship with your parents, love amongst poverty, and even some BDSM romance, which is why I would suggest teenagers and anybody below 18 to not read this book, but otherwise you should definitely check it out. Number three short story collection is Right Behind You. No, it's not Right Behind You, but the book's name is that. Can anybody give me the credit or at least a thumbs up for the PJ? Anyway, there are 13 short stories in this book. The themes and subgenres of these stories are also different. There are noirs, fantasies, myths, and even, I believe, an e-horror story. So yes, you can check it out as well. Number four is Haunted. It is actually a non-fiction with 10 short stories. Now, this is written in collaboration with Jay Alani, who I just found out is a paranormal investigator, and he has been investigating for over a decade now. And you know, this book is more about the stories that Jay Alani wanted to narrate, but written by Neil D. Silva. So writing is his, stories are of Jay Alani, the investigator in real life. And lastly, number five book is Ringa Ringa Roses. So it's actually something that you can, you know, like people from ages of 12 to 18 can also read. And it features three stories with young protagonists. There is a single child who is friends with a boy with strange powers who just manifests himself into the child's room. There is a boy who creates a replacement for his dead mother with a doll, and then the doll starts talking. And then there is a teenage orphan who finds shelter in a house which has horrifying stuff attached to it. So this book has fantasy, horror, and magical realism. And apart from this, there are three anthologies: When They Spoke, Vengeance, and City of Screams. So because this is not exactly Neil de Silva's work, I haven't done much research into it. Also, you should know that Neil de Silva is an author who is really supportive towards other authors. I mean, he keeps discussing about writing and he keeps trying to help out other people on how to write books. And this is something I really appreciate about him. And I believe one of these books was actually an anthology from... which was a product of a competition, so it's not really a book where he has written anything, but it has been compiled by him. That is again a little bit of speculation, but yes, these five short story collections that I discussed and the three novels are written by Neil de Silva, and these are something I definitely want to check out myself, and I would suggest you to check these out as well if you are into horror genre. And if you're always like Manpreet, suggests us something which is Indian horror, go check out these books. But before that, if you really want to support this channel, please make sure you hit a thumbs up to just get this algorithm running and, you know, have it recommend my videos to more people. So yes, your thumbs up is really important to me. And also comment down below if you like this video and if there is any other author you want me to feature in these videos, in this author series, please comment down below. And if you're watching me for the first time and if you're watching until now, oh my god, you're awesome. At the same time, this is a part of an author series where I discuss and try to tell you guys about more Indian authors. So there are more videos in this series that you can check below in the description. Actually, there's a playlist in the description that you can check out. Anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. This is Manvi signing off. I'll be back with another video very soon.